Now let's move on to another approximation method in quantum mechanics, again suitable for time independent problems. As we have already seen the perturbation theory and variational method, this is the third approximation method that we'll have to discuss in this category of approximation methods for time independent problems. This method is widely known as WKB approximation to commemorate the three physicists who introduced the method in quantum mechanics and are Wenzel, Crummers and Brillouin. It is known under different name in different regions. In Britain it is known as Jeffrey Wenzel Crummers Brillouin approximation, JWKB. In Holland it is called KBW method, and in Hungary it is called BKW method, etc. Though these names are related to the founders of the method or the physicists who coined this method, there are some other astonishing names under which also the method is well known. We will come across these very shortly as we move advance with the WKB approximation. General introduction to WKB. The method, as I have already told you, is introduced by Wenzel, Crummers and Brillouin. This method is further referred to as the semi-classical approximation, though as per the demand of our syllabus we discuss it as the third approximation method. This we might have discussed as the first approximation method. This actually gives a connection between quantum mechanics and classical mechanics in terms of the classical action and quantum mechanical action. Classical action, I'll represent it say a zero, and quantum mechanical action as a yes. Why it is called semi-classical approximation and why it is called phase integral method, all these things will be discussed very shortly. And at this point I'll tell you one thing, this method is suitable for generally one-dimensional problems, as in the case of one-dimensional harmonic oscillator like that. Or of course you can apply this method to three-dimensional problems or two-dimensional problems as well. However, there are methods of decomposing them into one-dimensional problems. So in general the method is suitable for one-dimensional problems or problems that can be decomposed into two or more one-dimensional problems. Now let's see the principle of this method. Following this we will talk about the criteria for the validity of the approximation method also, and this discussion will evidently tell you why it is called semi-classical approximation or how it is related to semi-classical approximation or how it is one step ahead of the classical approximation. As you know, the classical equation for Hamiltonian is for a system that is moving with a kinetic energy subjected to a potential say V, then the Hamiltonian is evidently the sum of the kinetic energy and potential energy, where kinetic energy is given in terms of the momentum as a P square by 2 mu plus V. And the corresponding equation of motion in classical mechanics could be written in terms of the Hamilton-Jacobi equation and in terms of the canonical equations. As you know, the Hamilton-Jacobi equation is H equal to minus time derivative of classical action. I have only one choice for action right now. That is why I have taken this action as say S as usual, or as you have discussed in classical mechanics for say using standard textbooks like Goldstein. So Hj equation is H equal to minus dou S by dou T. From this equation itself, clubbing with the Hamilton's canonical equation, say dP by dT or Pj dot equal to minus dou S by dou Q, you can write the momentum of the classical system as the gradient of the action. As you know, H is already equal to minus dou S by dou T, and the canonical equation tell you Qj dot equal to minus dou S by dou P and Pj dot or dp by dt equal to minus dou h by dou q, or this is equal to dou by dou q of h. H is already minus dou s by dou t. So minus dou s by dou t. Of course, there is one more minus here. These two minuses will be vanishing, and we obtain dp by dt equal to, or dou p by dou t equal to dou by dou q of dou s by dou t. As these differential operators are commuting, you can write this as dou by dou t of dou s by dou q. Dou s by dou q is nothing other than, say, grad s. So that dp by dt equal to d by dt of grad s. D by dt then vanishes. You have, say, on the left side, dou p by dou t, dou p by dou t equal to, on the right side, you have this dou by dou t taken out, dou by dou t of, what remains is dou s by dou q. That is the derivative of action with respect to the position coordinates or generalized position. That is nothing other than, say, grad s. So time derivative of momentum equal to time derivative of grad s indicate that p equal to grad s. So this is something that you have already come across in classical mechanics. So substitute for p equal to grad s. The analogous equation for the equation of motion in classical mechanics corresponding to this classical Hamiltonian is given by minus dou s by dou t equal to, substitute p equal to grad s, we obtain this as, say, grad s whole square divided by 2 mu plus v. So this is the classical equation of motion derivable from the classical Hamiltonian. And quantum mechanical Hamiltonian also has the exact format. You have Hamiltonian equal to the sum of the kinetic energy and potential energy. Then why cannot we try an equation of motion in quantum mechanics from, or starting from, this equation for Hamiltonian? Yeah, we will try it right now. An analogous equation of motion in quantum mechanics is nothing other than the time independent Schrodinger equation, that is given by ih cross dou psi by dou t equal to minus h bar square by 2 mu del square plus v operating over psi, where psi is, or psi can be written as, say, e raised to I by h cross s of r comma t, where s here being represented as a mathematical function of position and time is the quantum mechanical action. We are interested in obtaining an analogous equation, analogous to this classical equation, in terms of, say, classical action in quantum mechanics, that is in terms of quantum mechanical action. How come I come across this quantum mechanical action? This is also that you have discussed in quantum dynamics. You have seen that the Schrodinger equation in quantum mechanics is analogous to, or is complementary with, the HJ formalism in classical mechanics, whereas the Heisenberg formalism is complementary with the canonical formalism in classical mechanics. This you can obtain directly from the time dependent Schrodinger's equation, ih cross dou psi by dou t equal to h psi, or h equal to, take psi to the left side, and I in the numerator could be written as a minus I in the denominator. Is a very basic knowledge from complex analysis. Minus h cross by I, psi is written to the left side, 1 by psi dou psi by dou t, or this is equal to minus dou by dou t of h cross by I natural log psi. H cross by I is constant, natural log psi has a derivative, 1 by psi dou psi by dou t in terms of time. Now this is identical with the Hamilton-Jacobi equation that we have already written here, h equal to minus dou s by dou t. This is also exactly of the form h equal to minus dou by dou t of this quantity in this bracket should be then nothing other than, say, the quantum mechanical action. as it is dependent on psi, the wave function, which is a mathematical function of position and time, is also needed to be a mathematical function of position and time. So that we can write S equal to h cross by I natural log psi. So that natural log psi equal to I by h cross into S, or psi equal to exponential I by h cross into S. We mean substitute this value of psi in the Schrodinger's equation. For that we will have to evaluate, say, dou psi by dou t and del square psi. Dou psi by dou t is derivative, time derivative of this exponential function, that is exponential function itself, which is being written as a psi, into derivative of this quantity. Derivative of I by h cross into s is I by h cross dou s by dou t. And del square psi is evidently divergence of grad psi. That is, divergence of grad psi is gradient of this one. Gradient of this one is derivative of e raised to term with respect to the position coordinate, that is exponent has a derivative, exponent itself into derivative of this one. I by h cross is constant into gradient of S. Now psi is also dependent on position, grad s is also a vector depending upon position. So this divergence has to be taken for these two quantities, and I by h cross is constant. I by h cross is taken out. Del dot psi grad psi, that's of the form divergence of a vector, vector grad s and a scalar psi psi. That is psi into del dot grad s, which is del square s, plus second function grad s into derivative of this psi with respect to position. That is nothing other than psi into I by h cross into grad s. Psi into I by h cross into grad s is the second function. So you open this bracket, I by h cross psi del square s, I by h cross into I by h cross, make it say minus psi by h cross square. Grad s dot grad s is nothing other than say grad s whole square. This is the dot product of a vector with itself, and that give you the square of the magnitude of the vector. Now substitute these values of dou psi by dou t and del square psi in the Schrodinger's equation. We obtain the analogous equation of motion corresponding to this classical equation in terms of action in quantum mechanics. That is, I h cross dou psi by dou t equal to minus h bar square by 2 mu del square psi is written here, plus v psi. Dou psi by dou t I h cross into dou psi by dou t is I by h cross dou s by dou t into psi. Minus h bar square by 2 mu is used to open this bracket. Del square s I by h cross into minus h bar square by 2 mu is a negative term that is written here, and the positive term will be say this one. H cross square vanishes, minus make it say plus grad s whole square divided by 2 mu is there into psi. Grad s whole square by 2 mu plus v. Yeah, psi is taken as a common factor, and this term becomes 1 h cross vanishes minus I h cross by 2 mu minus I h cross by 2 mu del square s into psi. Divide the equation by psi, and simplifying this term, I square minus 1 h cross vanishes. So this is minus dou s by dou t equal to grad s whole square by 2 mu plus v plus minus I in the numerator is plus I in the denominator. So this is h cross by I into grad square s divided by 2. And this is the quantum mechanical analog of the classical equation that we have already come across. And this classical equation has only this much portion, whereas quantum mechanical equation has an additional portion, that is h cross by I del square s by 2 mu. Suppose this term is not there, you cannot make it say 0, or of course you cannot tell you that this term is not there. It's an assumption that suppose this term is negligibly smaller comparing with the term containing grad as whole square.